I am Dr. Amit Bhushan Sharma, Associate Director and Unit Head Cardiology, Paras Group of Hospitals. Our Department of Cardiology at Paras Hospital has successfully performed a world's smallest pacemaker called Micra during this lockdown with a new innovative technology. We have performed about 25 Micra so far, but this Micra which we have performed, this leadless pacemaker, has been unique in many ways. How this disease was managed uniquely during this COVID pandemic is the story, small story which I am trying to narrate. Here was an 83-year-old young patient, I would say, not old patient, 83 young patient with history of breathlessness and history of blackouts. Family was paranoid. They did not want to come to the hospital. They were scared of corona and the corona pandemic. We sent an external loop recorder at home to diagnose this condition. This was a small belt which was worn around the waist of the patient, and every minute, every second, it recorded the ECG, and if there's any abnormality, it used to come directly on the mobile, on my mobile or the physician's mobile. Now this ELR was sent for 5 days. On the second day we started noticing any abnormality in the ECG which came on my phone, and we immediately intimated the patient. And once the patient was informed, he was having lightheadedness at that point of time, and he came to the hospital in the midnight at 12 o'clock once he was called. We saw the ECG showed a heart rate of 20 beats per minute, which was damn scary for a pacemaker, and this is what the pacemaker looks like. So this is the size of a capsule, unlike a conventional pacemaker. And best part was that this was done through the leg veins, so the chances of cross-infection, like a conventional pacemaker wherein you are close to the patient's mouth and the nasal airways, is less. This was done through the leg veins without any suture, and the patient was sent home early morning the next day. Not only that, on follow-up he need not come to the hospital. We send him home with a mobile-sized telemetry device which he can attach to the chest, keep it on the chest, and whatever data is there will directly come on his physician's mobile, and we'll come to know without calling him to the hospital. So this practice has changed, revolutionized the practice of patient coming post follow-up or pre-follow-up. In this patient only came during the time when he required the device. He did not come pre-op and he did not come post-op for any follow-up. Elderlies, my message is elderlies should not ignore their symptoms. If they have their symptoms, please inform and please come to the hospital immediately, because cardiac diseases or sudden cardiac deaths can be as scary and as dangerous, or if not more, as compared to COVID. So please do not ignore your symptoms. You have to be alert but not scared of the disease.
This, my name, for those of you who know it, is Francis Rosa. And for those of you who don't know it, it's still Sir Francis Rosa, haven't changed. So I've been here in this in Paris Hospital now ever since Amit Bhushan Sharma has been here, and my experience has been incredibly good from the time I've been here. And the epitome of it was when I came here recently for what turned out to be the introduction of a pacemaker in my system. Attention of the staff, they never let me for a minute. I was reaching the stage, say, for God's sake, leave me alone. But it continued. I was given the royal treatment, and finally when I went in for the insertion of the pacemaker, the OT was something out of this world. And ever since then, I have been treated with extreme tender care all the time, and with a successful outcome. So I couldn't ask for more. My great entire gratitude and thanks to the entire staff of Paris, and particularly to Dr. Amit Bhushan Sharma and his assistants, for putting me on my feet again.